Hi guys, this is Harris Sultan. Now, I've been very careful about what to say and when to say it, because when it's a legal matter, you have to be very careful. Which is why it's important that I have to give you this disclaimer that none of what you are about to hear is coming from Zara K. And I'm speaking my mind based on the information that I have received from my sources. A lot of us have worked very hard for a number of years to build our reputation and credibility. And as much as we would all love to help out our friend Zara, I don't think any one of us would lie or keep you deliberately misinformed. I have always said that Maryam Namazi is the mother of this movement, and I don't think there's anyone in this movement that I respect more than Maryam. And I know Maryam has been keeping a very close eye on this case, and she's not an idiot. She won't be lying and putting a credibility that she worked so hard for on the line with Zara or anyone. And there is no need. We have truth on our side. None of us believe that these accusations are anything but politically motivated accusations from the local Khoja community. Well, when I say we, I mean I and some other people, and obviously not every so-called ex-Muslim activist falls under that. I know some Muslims have accused us of, oh, he's just looking for attention. I never believed that because that was never the case with me. And also, there is nothing wrong in drawing attention because you are drawing attention towards a cause that you think is very important. But now, I think I understand what they mean. They mean that he is drawing attention for himself as a person. Even though that might not be as bad as you think, but I can now understand. Sometimes people's heads get so far stuck up their backside that they can see nothing other than their hideous self. And in this case, I have discovered two such individuals. I wouldn't name the person who initially allegedly leaked Zara conversation to this spiteful, vengeful, deceitful, backstabbing woman named Faye. Not because I respect that person anymore, but because I'm being told that she's really regretful. She's feeling awful. She's actually blocked Faye, blah, blah, blah. Some other ex-Muslims have actually fallen into this propaganda dished out by Faye. And I don't blame people like Infidel Noodle or even Apostate Prophet. I still hold them my friends. And obviously, because they didn't know everything, they said what they said. For instance, once Infidel Noodle found out most of the story, she deleted her tweets immediately and blocked this shameless person. And I'm sure had Apostate Prophet spoken with one of us, he would not have condemned Zara or accused her of doing this and that or whatever he said. I would personally suggest that he should say something like what happened. He was being misled by this conniving, hateful person, or he might not say anything at all. It's actually up to him. So, who is this vengeful, hateful, spiteful person? Well, her name is Faye the Most Obnoxious. She and Zara actually used to be very good friends. So they once had an argument over some petty BLM matter, and Faye never got over it. She made so many videos, countless tweets, and lost countless friends as well. Because all the common friends they had blocked her out of their lives. Because it's not really that hard to see through her. So what, you have a disagreement over something. But how far will you go? This woman has been tweeting poison about Zara from the second or third day after she was arrested. And now she has the audacity to say, oh, I had been so worried about her, but look, she'd been lying to us. Go through her timeline, and if she hasn't deleted it yet, you would find plenty of poisonous tweets from her about Zara K from the second or third day onwards. She's been hoping that she rots in prison over some pesky argument that she had with her many months ago. Now let me tell you, most of you might not know, I once had a very serious disagreement with Abdullah Samir, and we didn't speak for nearly a year. But guess what? Nobody found out. Because we were adults. Nobody leaked anyone's private communication or publicly tried to humiliate anyone because we were adults. A benefit Zara didn't have because the person she had a disagreement with would get in bed with people like that introverted smile. And now, and this is even a new low for even someone as low as her, getting in bed with Ali Dawa? So this person in the group allegedly leaked her private conversation with Zara and passed it on to Faye. Faye was elated and over the moon, and the very next minute she created a fake account under the name Girl Ain't Lying. The irony. A person hiding behind a fake account ain't lying and demanding integrity? Own up if you want to say something, but no, she's a backstabber. She has thrown her family under the bus, and she would throw anyone under the bus. Now, you might say, oh, Harris, you don't know how evil was her family. Yes, you're right. I don't know. Nor I had any interest anymore. But if you remember, I once helped a Pakistani ex-Muslim atheist named Spartacus escape Pakistan. His mother conspired with the local cleric and had him tortured and eventually killed if he didn't convert back to Islam. Now, Spartacus only spoke about it once and doesn't speak about his parents anymore. You know why? Because he's an adult and moved on. But this woman is obviously incapable of moving on. She hates Zara so much that she tweets about her almost every day. She even said, hey, look, so I don't want to talk about Zara so that I muted the name Zara. She obviously needs help, and once Zara comes out, I can try to get Faithless Hijabi to fund a shrink for her. Okay, you might now be thinking, okay, Harris, we get it. This is a shameless individual, but what about the screenshots that show dishonesty and lack of transparency? The second charge is easy. Once this is over, you would know every little detail there is to be known. You would have to be an absolute idiot if you revealed all of your legal strategies. I don't think Zara should discuss her legal strategy on Twitter. And I understand that. Why? So people like Ali Dawa and Faye can have their popcorns and bitch and moan? Now, what about the dishonesty charge? Well, there is no dishonesty in discussing things privately with your team. If you're having a discussion with your lawyer or your team and you say, maybe we shouldn't go to the media right now. Or someone says, no, maybe we should go to the media right now. Is that dishonesty? No, that's thinking out loud about your legal strategy moving forward. Now, let's have a look what actually happened. Now, Zara was summoned to a police station and she suspected it's because of blasphemy. Now, was she wrong in thinking that? What is Zara known for? Is she known for her criticism of dictators around the world? She might have occasionally spoken about it every now and then, but she's not known for it. Or is she known for her ties with criminal gangs around the world? No, she's known for her criticism of Islam. And her enemies are those butthead individuals who think she's guilty of blasphemy. Who would come after me? China? Trumpians? No, some butthead peaceful would come after me or after AP or Zara. So she was absolutely right. And guess what? I don't know about Zara, but I still believe that it was the local Khoja Shia community that went after her. You have to be a world-class idiot if you think that the police would know highly technical details like she's using a SIM card that's registered under her family member's name. I still believe some butthead from the local Shia community spoke with some local police officers and conspired how to teach this girl a lesson. And they found a couple of posts in which she was critical of the president, way, way back when she was in the UK. They knew there's no blasphemy charge, but you think they would say, oh, there is no blasphemy charge, so we should let her go. And all these activists should know better. All of these activists experience this almost every day. These butthurt peacefuls report our videos every day, not for blasphemy, because there is no blasphemy report in YouTube. They will throw everything at you that would stick. So they threw this critical of the president accusation, hoping that the Tanzanian government will support them as it involves the president. The president probably didn't even know that. And then they threw their favorite charge using a SIM that's not under your name. Quite ironic. They threw the same charge at another activist who was actually critical of the president, the Tanzanian comedian Idris Sultan. Oh yeah, he must be some serious criminal using some evil SIM card under a family member's name. And it probably had nothing to do with him being critical of the president. Right. Actually, the law is that you cannot register a SIM under someone else's name. And that's not what Zara did. Her family member just gave her their phone. All those people saying, oh, well, she did break the law, need to have a very hard look at yourself and ask, would they never use their family member's phone? Would they even know it's a crime? When I went to Italy last year, I took out 2 SIM cards under my name. One for my partner and one for myself. Am I supposed to know every little law in Italy? Of course you wouldn't. This is not even a crime. Their own law says that you cannot get a SIM card under someone else's name. And as I said, this is not something that Zara did. Now, how would a police officer know that Zara is an Australian citizen and on top of that, she didn't surrender her Tanzanian passport? Obviously, someone who hates her would volunteer that info. And as far as being critical of the president is concerned, even that is not a crime. According to Tanzanian law, the crime is sedition. Those so-called critical posts could be anything, but not sedition. Lastly, have a look. Zara was released on bail on 29th of December, and none of us said she's been arrested for blasphemy. And this is what I said on 30th of December. I tweeted and said, who is behind Zara K's arrest? Allegedly, it's the local Shia community. A young Australian human rights activist has been jailed for highly politically motivated charges. Where was blasphemy in this? We are allowed to suspect. Only an idiot would think a random police officer was somehow aware that she hasn't returned her Tanzanian passport or the phone in her pocket is not under her name. Where did I say, oh, please help us, our friend is a victim of blasphemy? Nobody said that. Now, did we say release her? She's not out on bail? No, we didn't say that either. But when I was reading my tweets, I actually realized I actually made a different mistake. I used the word jailed instead of arrested. Now that's an honest error, which I only realized today. And that's my fault. I didn't say she's been arrested for blasphemy. It's my mistake, and Zara obviously has got nothing to do with it. Now let's have a look what Mariam Namazi said. Urgent action. Tanzanian government must drop all politically motivated charges against Zara K immediately and unconditionally. Again, where did she lie? Our demand at that point was drop all the politically motivated charges. And guess what? It's still our demand. Now, as far as the hashtags are concerned, who gets caught up on that? My Twitter banner still says, release Zara K. Obviously, in light of the later information, she still hasn't been let go. She still has to report to the local police station every day, while none of the charges have been officially laid. So let me say it again. Release Zara K, which means let Zara K go, which means drop all charges, which means give her passport back so she can go back home. Now let's have a look if we fed any false information to any media. Now I spoke with the newspaper The Australian and it said, Aussie held, accused of sedition. And it said the same thing. Miss K was held for 32 hours and she was asked about her SIM card and passport. The link is in the description and you can go through it. There is not a single lie in that piece. This piece was printed on 4th of January. It went online on 3rd of January. It was a horrible time for us to get a hold of journalists because most of our contacts were away on Christmas and New Year holidays. In fact, the writer of this piece, Caroline Overington, was still on holidays, but she agreed to speak with me. Someone else spoke with ABC. You can go through that as well. Again, there's not a single lie in that piece. The only news agency, to the best of my knowledge, said Zara K arrested for blasphemy was Dailymail. And as far as I know, none of us spoke with Daily Mail. And they probably just did their own research and said whatever they said. None of the newspapers that spoke with us said she was arrested for blasphemy to gather some sympathy votes. So since I've set the record straight, now let me answer the silliest charge that is being laid out by some ex-Muslims. Oh, she did it to gain sympathy. So asking for help is gaining sympathy? Your friends reaching out to consulates and journalists is seeking sympathy? Now think about it. If you answer yes to these questions, then pray to the almighty Einstein that you are never arrested, because if you try to ask for help, you will be called, oh, he's doing it to gain sympathy. Let me say that again. There were no lies. There were no fabrications. There were no sympathy gaining tactics. There's not a single lie in any of this. It's all on record. And I'm sure when Zara is out, she'll tell you everything there is to be told. But I'm hoping she's not going to say everything on social media until she's out of the harm's way. And neither would you if you were in her place. Only an idiot would do that. Actually, only an attention-seeking idiot would do that. Hey, look, I've been arrested for blasphemy. Hey, look, I've been assaulted. But Zara never said any of that because she's a person of integrity. And I trust her. And Faye, you should be ashamed of yourself. We would have done the same thing for you, stood by you, and helped you out to the best of our abilities. But I hope you never find yourself in this situation, because if you do, I think you would find yourself very alone. Just like the people you tried to manipulate, and who initially fell for your lies, but when they found out the truth, they all blocked you. Zara is still going through this. She still needs our support, and all of your respected ex-Muslim activists you love and respect are all standing by her, with the exception of few who obviously were misled and lied to. Anyway, I'll see you next time.